Hello, everyone. This is D-Vang. Welcome to the episode 15 of the Outlaw Joseph Scott's, entitled "I Know What You Did Last Summoning." All right, if that gives you a clue, his current mission is to delve into the mines and stop a ritual summoning from happening. Apparently, there's some evil beasties coming through a portal, and he's kind of going there to stop the summoning ritual. So, last episode, episode 14, he was in town, and it went pretty well. Nothing too earth-shattering. He was able to pick up some Darkstone bullets, so he's in really good shape. One gun has a Darkstone grip, and he was a little low on money, but other than that, not too shabby, not too shabby. So, here we are. Let's... what I'm going to do is actually, instead of going straight into gameplay, because this mission actually has a fixed map, and I do have a table that's large enough to hold it, what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you guys kind of a top-down overview first, where you can kind of see the whole map laid out in its glory, and then I will change the camera position for a little more closer and easier to manage gameplay. So, hold on. And enjoy the episode. Okay, so here is a high-level overview of the map for this mission. I'm not going to play the game this way, but figured you might appreciate having just sort of a top-down look kind of at the scale of this map and all that's going into it. Down at the bottom there, we've got the mine entrance, and then there are a number of rooms. Each has an exploration token hidden on it, or, you know, already placed, but hidden on it. Where you see those gates are, those actually aren't gates. Those are sort of potential exits to the summoning chamber room map tile. I put the gates there just because it's a little easier to see where those four exits are. And you'll see on each of those exits there is a face-down token. It is a number, one of the square number tokens, kind of like this one. They're numbered 1 through 4. And obviously, basically what the objective is to get into each of the rooms, or get in each time I go into one of the rooms that connects to one of those exits, and I clear that room out of, you know, resolve whatever is on the encounter token. Exploration token, then I reveal that chit, and if that's the number one, that is the exit to the summoning chamber. Obviously, one of those four is the summoning, is going to be the summoning chamber. It is a lot of distance to cover, so there is going to be a little bit of a time crunch on this, but you can kind of see there's no drawing of exploration tokens during the game. The depth track will work a little bit differently, which I'll read the rules for that and explain it. But here you can kind of see the map from top down. See it all laid out in its glory. It's, you know, takes up, I guess, 2/3 of my table here when it's all laid out. There's actually some decent room on this. This is actually, I think, one of the slightly smaller fixed map ones. I think there's another one or two that are just a little bit bigger. I mean, they're not too much bigger, but it is also, you know, even though my table's big enough, it will be a little bit of a challenge to film it all. We'll see how that goes when I go back down. Obviously, I mean, I'm extended as far as I can on this tripod, and I can barely fit and zoomed out as much as I can on the camera, and it's still barely fitting on this on the screen. So here you go. Here's the map, and give me a moment here to reset the camera, and then I will begin gameplay. Okay, so here we are again, a little bit closer view, and obviously I can zoom in from here, which would be nice. So this mission is Stop the Ritual. Rumors have been swirling about a secret cult down in the mines that worship the dark gods of old. The tales tell of human sacrifice and summoning rituals designed to break down the barriers between worlds and bring demonic creatures through. If true, this has to be stopped. Okay. So, obviously I've kind of mentioned briefly about the setup. The goal, obviously, is to find the summoning chamber and then stop the ritual. So basically I have to find the summoning chamber, beat a high threat that's in the summoning chamber, and once there are no more enemies on the board, I win the mission. So that is the ultimate goal. Special rules are that the hero posse marker is not positioned at the mine entrance and it does not move per room explored, obviously, because this is a fixed layout map. So what is going to happen is we actually start it here at the top of the track, and the first number space, and then for each exit that I reveal, I roll a d6 on a 1, 2, or 3. Let me double check here. Yes, 1, 2, or 3. It'll jump to the next position on the track. The darkness portion still moves up as normal, so time will be of the essence on trying to get to these locations as quickly as possible. The gate exits on the map. Pan over here, you can kind of see one over here. Okay, that's not actually a gate. That is just used to help me represent that is one of the four exits. And then there's a special rule once in the summoning chamber that during the final fight, anytime a holdback, the darkness roll is failed. We roll a d6. And on a 1, 2, or 3, we add a low threat card to the fight as monsters are being summoned. So it could take a long time. It could become very dangerous, especially if we get too low on the depth track there and have a 9+, say, to hold back the darkness. There we go. As a reward for successfully completing, each hero will gain 50 experience points. If the heroes fail, which they might, I am just doing Joseph. I decided against making up a new fourth level hero to join him. So he's going it alone again. But I do have Darkstone bullets this time. And back to what I was saying. If he fails, the darkness summoned from the portal escapes the mines and wreaks havoc on the countryside and the neighboring towns. When he travels to the next frontier town, two buildings there have been destroyed by the darkness. There you go. So those are the rules for this mission. Joseph has his one grit, his two revives. I think we're all set. So my basic strategy, I'm going to let you know right now. If you can remember back or go back and look at the overhead view of the map, is it's actually a shorter distance to go to the right here, up there, to get to that first exit than it is to go to the left down there. It's fewer it's more map tiles, but it's slightly shorter, and the fact that those two on the right there are really close, and it's a pretty quick jaunt even get over that third one. This one in the lower left corner is pretty far away, sort of by itself. So I'm going to leave that one for last. Hopefully that's not my undoing. Hopefully that is not the one that has the number one on it, but this way I think I can cover three of them fairly quickly. So let us start here by holding back the darkness. A 9, that is a good start. And then Joseph rolls for his movement. A 5 and a 3, so we will take the 5 because there's no read. I don't want to dawdle here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And Joseph will go ahead and attempt to scavenge. Do that once or twice in the game. Gets 2 scavenge cards. Sort of the Good news is I don't have to waste time exploring, looking through doorways, to reveal the map. So he should be able to move at a pretty good clip. Okay, and his two scavenge are nothing and a small find for $50. Excellent. Okay. The mine entrance has been scavenged. So, second turn. Oops, hold back the darkness. That was a 6 and a 2. So that's an 8, which is good enough. And Joseph will then move. See if I can keep them in the box this time. 5 and a 3. Well, unfortunately, no ones to get some grit, but we'll live with that. We'll go 1. 2, 3, 4, 5, just shy of that next map tile. Let us see what is on this. It is an attack. Oops, down here. Sorry. It is an attack. And I should shift the camera up here. Zoom in a bit. Sorry, it's a little dark. I was getting a lot of glare. Hopefully it's not too dark to see the map. Looks like it's probably okay. So, he's attacked. It will slow him down. Fortunately, it's not an encounter. And he is attacked by 6 void spiders. Now remember, enemies get placed away from the mine entrance, which is down that way, to the left, and as far back. So that's why instead of, it doesn't matter where Joseph is, that is where they're going to go. Okay, and the void spiders have 2... Trying to get this box... Kind of... Zoom in a bit. Actually, let me see if I turn the overhead light on, if I've gotten rid of the glare. Yeah, there's still a little bit of glare, but I think that still might be better here. Okay, because it was pretty dark. All right, so the void spiders have 2 elite abilities, which are a 4 and a 2. You can kind of see that. Okay. All right, the 2 is Void Venom. So any hero that takes 1 or more wounds from a Void Spider is -1 to hit on all of their attacks. Well, that will suck. And a 4, they are +2 defense. They are 3 health, 2 defense. So good thing I have some Darkstone bullets. So we need to hold back the darkness again. Oops, can't quite see that, can you? All right, there we go. So 6 and a 2, so 8. So gotten lucky on that so far. So the void spiders will move first. So they will all pile in on poor Joseph here. Oh, I just noticed I only have 5. We have a 6-1 here. So, lucky for Joseph, only 5 can attack him where he is. Alright, so they have 2 dice each. I have a combat of 2. So that's going to be 10 dice hitting on 4s. Wow. Alright, Joseph, I am rolling pretty well for them right now. That is unfortunate. That's way above half. So that's 7 hits. Alright, so Joseph has to save against 7 hits. Well, that's not too bad. He will use a grit. to reroll these four dice, because each one is two that he's saving against, two wounds. All right, so that was the equivalent of four defense rolls. All right, so now he has four defense rolls for his armor rolls. Saves one. So that is six wounds and void venom. It's not a good start. All right, so he's got this lovely void venom minus one to hit token. And then it is his turn. So now he needs to roll for his movement. Four and a three, won't do anything. And then he gets to shoot. So he has four dice with one pistol, three dice with the other, needing fives. That was pretty bad. Pretty bad. No sixes. Even needing fours, that was pretty horrible. All right, so Joseph gets to re-roll three dice. So I have one for each gun for his skill, and one for the bandolier. Two hits. All right, well, not looking good. All right, so one-on-one spider. We're gonna do the back ones to keep that one out of the fight. So let's move him, I'll turn him around. He's actually gonna shoot those two. So the first one. All right, so I need a five total because they have two defense and three health. So I need a five total to kill them. I am plus one, so I need a four or better to kill it. And a one will not do it. Let's try again. Okay, well, that will kill one. And then it is time to hold back the void venom goes away because it was only for his next activation. Hold back the darkness, succeeds. Again, a six and a two. All right, so then he's attacked with eight dice, needing fours. Well, that's better. That's the roll I needed last time. All right, so three hits, defense. Saves two. So that's two potential wounds, so two armor saves. Saves one, so he takes one wound, but he does get the void venom back, because he did take a wound. And then it is Joseph's turn, so roll for movements. No grit. And I don't think he can get anywhere. Well, yeah, and I don't want to go into the tile and potentially get another attack. So he's just going to shoot again. Hopefully get a couple sixes and take these guys out. Get this a little closer. There we go. All right. Unfortunately, the fours miss. So we got one six. And then he gets three rerolls. Okay. All right, so that's three hits because the six count as two hits. All right, so again, we'll work our way this way. So the one on the end there. All right, well, a two plus one is three, so that's enough to do one wound to him. Let's hit the next one in line. Okay, four, that's five, that's an outright kill. Good. All right, and then I'm going to go back to the wounded one with the third hit. That's another one wound. But that does allow one kill. Actually, he's had two kills. I forgot, that is his second kill. So he actually gets to heal one because of the silver buckle. So he actually healed two wounds total. One wound for the first one that died, and another wound for the one that just died. So, that is the end of that turn. We hold back the darkness again. Double fours on the depth event chart is falling rubble. Each hero in the mines immediately takes d6 hits. 5. Joseph takes 5 hits. So 5 defense rolls. He saves 1. And then 4 armor rolls. He saves 1, so he takes 3 wounds. 3 more wounds. Well, but the death track does not move still. And then he's attacked by 3. 2, 4, 6. 6 dice. Hitting on 4s, so 2. 2 hits. That's nice, not bad. Defense rolls. Saves both of them. So he does not have the minus 1 this round. So hopefully, this will finish them off. Enough hits. Yes, there we go, big hits. Well, of course, that would have hit even with the Void Venom, because they were all 6s that hit there. He does get his 3 rerolls. They hit 2 more. Okay, and then each of those 3 sixes is an extra die. So that's 8 hits. All right. So I'm actually going to put these one at a time on the unwounded ones to try to kill them off. I need a 4 better to outright kill him. So the first one, that will kill one. And allow him to heal 1. Next. A 3 plus 1 is 4 minus 2 is 2 wounds. Not quite enough to kill the one that's adjacent to him. He actually has to shoot the ones that are adjacent first, so he's going to hit the far one now. We just said that's 2 wounds. He's already got 2 wounds, so that will kill him. And allow Joseph to heal another wound. Okay, that's all right. Still got five. All right, so attack again. Damage 5 is enough to kill this one. And Joseph heals another wound. And then he has 4 rolls. Kills that, 4 damage left, so that kills him and lets him heal back 1 more. Okay, so he's at 4 wounds left. And that is the end of the combat, so catching his breath, he can heal 2 of those, so he actually came out with only 2 wounds from that, which is pretty good. Considering it looked like it was going to start off very rough, indeed. And then that is, and then a loot card. Loot. Loot card is, what is this? Draw an artifact card. Which I'm looking up. Kind of artifact can Joseph get? Now Joseph is sitting at, actually I guess he has room to carry things because 3, 4, 5, right, he's only got 5 because he had to get rid of something, and he can carry 7, so he can actually carry 2 things, and his artifact is another amulet of Kotak, the one that was stolen from him by the Inquisitor of the Crimson Hand. Well, that's odd. All right. Okay. Fate. It was mine. It was meant to be mine, apparently. Let us move on. That is the end of that turn. So we will hold back the darkness. And 11, we do. Joseph then gets to move. A 2 or a 2. All right. I guess he's moving 2. And just in case they don't move, well, I do need to get through this pretty quickly, so I'll go ahead and move forward, and we'll see what happens. So let's reveal the exploration token. Actually, let me shift the map over this way, or the camera over, so you can see it a little bit better. And I don't want to get that too close. All right. Let's see what this exploration token is. It is an encounter. Encounter is warning from the grave. A skeletal figure slumped against the passage wall seems to have scratched a warning into the stone. Make a cunning 5+ test. If successful, gain 25 experience points and take this card. I had this one last time. All right. Well, cunning. Three dice for cunning. And a single five. I got more than a single five. Two fives and a six is good. All right, so I get 25 experience points and get three extra dice on his kill test, or give himself plus three initiative. Well, that's nice. So, back to holding back the darkness. Five, boo. All right, so that's a fail. And then movement. Well, we'll take the five. Let's get out of this room and let's move to the next one. One, two, three, four, five. That is actually just enough to get him there to the next room. There we go. The dice box up here. Let us see what the exploration token is, and it is another attack. Apparently I drew all the attack tokens. So the next threat is a peril dice worth of tentacles. I don't like tentacles. Tentacles are nasty. So let me grab, and there are, three tentacles. And yes, I've been bad. I have not painted my tentacles yet. Three tentacles. Surprising how fast tentacles can move. They can move six. Luckily, they only have an initiative two. I've got a range of five. Smidge. One, two, three, four, five. All right, so they are actually exactly at five away. All right, that's good to know. So we will start with holding back the darkness. A three will not do it. That raises it to two, and that gives us a darkness card. Darkness card says, suffocating mist, darkness poison remains in play. A green mist fills the passage, choking the heroes in a poisonous fume. Each hero takes three hits. Also place this, basically on this map tile, since it's the only one that has a hero on it. And if he ends his move on this map tile, he will take two hits. We'll set this over here. So it takes three hits automatically, and that is, by the way, poison. And if I had gone to the doctor and gotten the injection. Oh, wait, did I get the injection? Hold on for a moment. Okay, so I did check, and of course, wouldn't you know it, the one day that I actually don't go to, one town say that I don't go to the doctor's office, I do get the injection. Of course, I didn't go to the doctor's office at all, but I did not get the injection, so I do, now, of course, I do draw the poison encounter or darkness card that is poison, otherwise you'd be immune to it. So, because that is a poison effect. It has the keyword poison on it, in fact. That is how you know that it applies. So, Joseph takes three hits. They are just hits, though, so his defense does work. So, he blocks one of them. And armor does count. Strangely, his helmet helps him. I guess he's breathing through it. It is kind of mask-like. And it protects him against one more. So he takes one wound from the miss, and then he rolls for movement. So in essence, I do not want to stay on that map tile. But he rolls a two or a two for movement. And I was hoping actually that I could get around to the corner tile there. That still would have taken a bit of moving. One, two, three, four. I would have needed a five. But regardless, with a two, he does not have enough. So we will leave it at that. I'll have to wait till next turn and potentially back up one space if I can. Only have a range of 5. So I will go ahead and shoot and hope I can kill one or two of these tentacles before they get to me and get a strike at me. Oh, I should roll for the tentacles' 2 elite abilities, which are a 3 and a 6. Okay, the 3 makes the tentacles plus 2 defense. They're now a 5 defense, jeez. And they are plus 2 initiative, which means they're initiative 4, which means they're tied with me and they actually go first. So we can ignore Joseph's turn for right now. And it is the tentacles get to go. Wow, 4 health and 5 defense. They are tough. All right, well, they get to move 6. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. All right, they will hem him in there. And, oops, sorry. Can zoom in a bit. Poor Joseph. Okay. Each tentacle has 3 dice, so that's 9 dice sitting on 4s. And 6s ignore his defense. So we've got 2 that ignore defense. Here, I guess I should separate them in the box, make it a little, sorry, 3 that ignore defense, and 2 that give him defense, and they do 3 damage each. Tentacles being the nasty things that they are. All right, so I have 2 defense rolls. Wow, all right, blocks them both. So, 3 hits times 3 wounds each for armor. So 9 armor saves. Blocks 3. So that is 6 wounds. So Joseph is up to 9 wounds. And now it is Joseph's turn. So now Joseph gets to roll the move. 5 and a 3. Well, that is a good question. So now he has a 5. Well, he wouldn't get to see them, but the 3 extra hits for taking the miss. Oh, you know what? I think I'm going to try to use the 5. I'm going to... I won't be able to shoot them. And they move 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So all 3 of them would still be able to attack. You know, I think I need to try to take these guys out. So he will end his movement on that tile and take 2 hits. So defense doesn't save. Armor doesn't save, so that's 2 more wounds. Joseph's up to 11 wounds. And then he will take his shot here. 7 dice hitting on 4s. Well, that's not too bad. Alright, so set those to the side. He gets his 3 rerolls. Well, that's nice. Nice. Excellent. So there are 2 6s, so that will add 2 more dice. That's a total of 8 dice. Well, he has no grit to reroll any of these. So we might as well. We'll roll them 1 at a time. Here. Doesn't really matter which one. I want to try to open a space on this tile, so I'm gonna go ahead and hit him first. So they are a 5 defense, so I need a 5 to do any sort of wounds to them. They only have 4 health each. They have 5 defense. So a 5 will do 1, a 6 will do 2. So the first hit, 5, does 1 wound. Next, nothing. Nothing. We'll do one wound. Nothing. 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 In the box. Nothing. Tentacles, I think, are probably the toughest enemy in the game, personally. Just with the amount of damage they do, the number of dice they roll, they got a good mix of defense and health. Of course, it doesn't help that they're... Oh, actually, they're only 4 defense. So that's actually 2 extra wounds. I'm sorry, they're plus 2 defense, and they have a defense of 2. So those 5s, and do each do 2 wounds each, because I'm a 5 plus 1 is 6, minus 4 is 2. So that actually is just enough to... I didn't think I rolled any 4s on my damage, so... Let's him heal 1 wound and kill 1 tentacle. And then it is time to hold back the darkness. Which I do. Well, that's fortunate anyway. The tentacles get to go. 6 dice sitting on 4s. And 6 is ignore defense. So he gets 1 defense roll. Hey, which blocks it. That's good. So that is 6 hits that he has to defend against. Or 6 points of death, 6 wounds on his armor. Which, wow, nice. Blocks 4 of them. So he only takes, so he takes 2 wounds. So he's at 12. And then it's Joseph's turn. Joseph rolls for his movement. Double 6s. Now I get double 6s. Don't need them. But I am going to try to escape because I want to get off that map tile. So they are a 4 plus. Failed, but I have the bandana, which gives me a reroll. Succeeds. Good. So I'm actually just going to move because I don't want to get too far from here if that is ends up being the exit. Oh, and I also don't want to go too far because either way I need to get through that room quickly. So I'm just going to go 1, get me off that tile so I don't take those extra hits. And then Joseph will attack here. So 7 dice hitting on 4s. Okay. So that's good. 3 sixes and a 4. Okay, and then rerolls. Unfortunately, the 3 sixes were all with 1 pistol. So Joseph's ability lets him reroll 1 die for each pistol. So he gets, instead of getting 3 dice rerolls, he only gets 2. 1 for the white die and 1 for the bandolier. Well, that's another 6 and another 4. All right, well, the 6s give me 4 more dice, 4 hits. This could be good. Okay, so I need 4s to do damage. I will go ahead and I'm gonna roll 2 at a time, just so this should speed it up a little bit. So a pair of 5s. So that's 2, 4. So that's enough to kill 1 and the rest on the other one. Got just enough, actually nothing. Those are the only 2 dice that did any damage to him. So that is enough to kill him. Boom. Kablow. Dead tentacles. Twitching and writhing. Alright, and that's 2 wounds that he gets to heal for his belt buckle. And then, catching his breath, he gets 1, so he's down to 9 wounds. And then he gets a loot card. And his loot card is D3 Darkstone. 3 pieces of darkstone. More darkstone, please. Yes. Okay. And now, the moment of truth here. So I'm going to flip this over. If this is a 1, it is not. It is a 4. Okay, so that is not the exit that we are looking for. So that actually gets replaced. Closes it off. Oops. Sorry. There you go. Shift it a little bit, closes it off. And we have this nasty card still on that map tile. And then, actually, I think Joseph is going to use a bandages. He has 3 of them. He's going to use one of them to try to heal. He said he has 9 wounds. He can heal 5. Perfect. So now Joseph gets to hold back the darkness. 2s. That will not hold back the darkness. Dark Dread. Things are looking more and more bleak. Draw a Growing Dread card and add it to the stack. So, we add a Growing Dread card. And now, Joseph rolls for his movement. Sorry, that is a 6 and a 3. I think I will take the 6, definitely, to get through, run through this room. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Just enough. Which makes sense since I needed a 5 to get there last time. So holding back the darkness again for Joseph. Oh, yeah, sorry. Sort of rewind. Since I revealed that, I have to roll a die to see if the track moves. A 4, it does not. It's a 1, 2, or 3, and the posse marker would move on the depth track. So it does not. Phew. And then Joseph gets to hold back the darkness again. Oh wait, didn't I just... No, that was for his move there. Okay, so a 3 fails. We'll move him up. We're now 3 on the depth track, which actually isn't too bad considering where we are. We had several good successful ones early on and then a couple doubles. So Joseph gets to move into the big room with double 4s for movement. Okay, let's shift the camera up here and zoom in a bit. Now Joseph needs to decide where he's going to go. All right, so he has 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. There really isn't any place where he can get... Can't really get... There's no place in here that's going to be, you know, way to minimize the number of attacks that he can get. Can't get across into the corridor over there, which might help. So I guess he's actually just going to go 1, 2. Put him in a position. If he needs to go that way, he can go that way. If he needs to go this way, he can go this way. Kind of a mix. All right, so let's see what this exploration token is. It is another attack. I don't know if you can see that. There we go. It is another attack. Boy, I don't know if there are any other attack to encounter tokens. Seems like I'm certainly drawing all of them when I place these. Okay, well, he's attacked by another low threat, which is a Peril Dice of Hellbats. So let us see how many Hellbats can we spawn. 3. Just 3. That's not too bad. Alright, so we're 3 Hellbats, and the Hellbats... Elite abilities are a 4 and a 3. So let's see what those are. A 3 is Shadow Wings, gives them +2 defense. Nice, alright. I mean, nice for them, not for me. And a Barb Tail gives them +1 combat. I'm rolling all the worst ones. I wouldn't mind taking the extra horror hits or things like that, or give them a few more health. So, it will be holding back the darkness again. A 10 will certainly hold back the darkness. Move the box a little bit more. That way so you can see into it better. Okay. So the Hellbats, with their initiative 6, will go first. And of course they will fly around. I'll turn Joseph around to take a look at them. Joseph versus his Hellbats. Not too many of them, though, which is a good thing. All right, shift the box a little bit. Okay. So, 3 Hellbats. They're going to roll 3 dice each. Hitting on 3s. Okay. It's actually not too bad. Too bad. So 5 hits. So, I'll remember that. 5 hits. So 5 defense rolls. Oops, that needs to get in the box. Saves 2. They do 1 point of damage each, so armor saves. Save 2. So he takes 1 wound. And it puts him up to 5 wounds total now. And then he has to make 5 willpower saves. And he makes 3 of them, and he takes 2 points of sanity damage. Then it is Joseph's turn. Time to lay some smack down on these foul flying fiends. Hitting on 4s. Pretty horrible. Alright, well, he gets his 3. 3 rerolls. 1 more hit. And then he gets a 1 extra hit for the 6. So 4 hits total. Now the Hellbats are now a 4 defense with 1 health. So it's a 5 to kill them. So I need a 4 or better. On each die, because I have plus 1 damage because of the Darkstone bullets. So we will start this way, that's sure. So 4 or better. 4. 4 will kill it. And he will heal a wound. Second damage roll. 6 will kill it. And he will heal a wound. 2 dice left. 6 and a 4 is enough to kill it. And he will heal. Yes, he'll still heal a wound. That was pretty painless, even with the armor. Again, thank heavens for the Darkstone bullets. So, and Joseph gets to catch his breath for 1. He will take a... Yeah, you know what? He's going to take a wound. Yeah, he'll 1 wound. And then, which leaves him at 1 wound and 2 sanity damage. And then he gets a loot card. Good news is, all these attacks are giving him loot cards. And other than that first round of tentacles, he's actually in a pretty good spot. So, and he gets a, this should come in handy, draw a gear card. So let us see what kind of gear he draws. He draws a vicious axe. Not useful for him, but it's worth 500, so he is at max capacity, so he may have to drop something. Well, we will have to see. All right, now we get to flip over this token to see whether this is the exit to, can you guys see this? Can't quite see this. Let's come over here and flip over that token. Let us see whether that is the exit to the summoning room, and it is. It is. So I chose right. I chose correctly. I said right is right, right? All right. So, take this off. And put the summoning chamber here. Okay. Here we go. One summoning chamber. And I also need to roll. Oh no, I don't have to roll for the darkness chart. Because it says if it's any other number than one. And then you roll a d6. The depth track posse marker has not moved in the depth track yet. And will not now. But this is the final boss, so we get a high threat. Ooh, it's exciting. Okay, and we get three slashers. Three slashers as his end goal, so let's place them here. Oops, actually, you go there. Okay. Now each time Joseph fails, they hold back the darkness roll. Three evil slashers coming for him. I guess they will kind of meet in the middle there. Good news is we're so far away that Joseph will actually end up getting, even though they've got initiative because they're tied at initiative 4, Joseph, they will move forward but won't reach him. Joseph will be able to step forward and make some shots and hopefully kill some of them. But as I was saying, the challenge being if I fail to hold back the darkness roll, I have a chance to get more enemies and I have to kill those enemies or kill all of the enemies in play before I can win. So I need to kill stuff as quickly as possible. But here we go, speaking of which, holding back the darkness, a 7, which is enough to hold back the darkness. So the slashers get to move at this point. And they have a movement of 5. Oh, sorry, I get to roll for their elite abilities. I don't remember that. Can't have the same one twice. So they have a 1 and a 4. So the 1 is plus 2 initiative. They're actually 6 initiative, which actually doesn't make a big deal. And a 4, Slasher's Fear 2 is replaced with Terror 2. And it's basically, if I'm on the same map tile, not just adjacent, I have to make fear tests against them. Okay. I can deal with that. So they move 5. So they're going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And he's going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And he's going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Boom. So here they come. I'm 5 away from one guy here. So I don't have to move. I'm going to start my activation anyway on the same map tile as one of them. So I do have to make a test for here. Because I'm on the same map dial, because he, I don't know how well you can see it, but this guy is actually on the seam of the big bone room. So, 2 willpower tests. How well can you see that? You can't. Okay. Tell you what, I'm actually going to shift the map a bit, bring everything a little bit closer so it's a little bit easier to see and not quite so far away. Hold on. Okay, so I did pull the map apart just a little bit. I'm not planning on, I don't really have to go anywhere else, obviously, unless I need to back up to avoid enemies or something, but it's unlikely. So I'm pretty much right here. So this was his movement, 3 and a 2. So I think Joseph wants to move slightly closer, because he wants to be able to hit more than just the one guy. They are defensive 4 with 6 health. So actually, you know what? Maybe he'll just take the one. 1, 2. Yeah, you know what? He's just gonna try to pick them off one at a time. At least for this round. So he's actually not going to move. Just shoot from there. There is his roll to hit. looks like. You can see all the dice, okay? Pretty well. You can't see this one. It's kind of tucked in there as a three. So 6, 5, and a 4. Gets his 3 rerolls. Only gets 1 more hit. Okay, but he does get 1 more die for the 6, so that's 5 hits. You know what? I'm actually going to use my Worn Eye Patch to recover up to my maximum grit, which gives him 3 grit. So that will be useful for defense next turn, and I think I got 5 dice, and I'm going to re-roll if necessary to kill this one, that lead, because I can only hit that one, that lead slasher. So they are a 4 defense, so I need a 3 to do any damage to them. Okay. So this is a 7 minus 4 is 3 wounds, and 2 wounds puts him 1 wound away because he's at 5 wounds and they have 6. So I think I will use a grit to reroll these 3 dice. And I get nothing. 3 twos. Needed a single 4 or better. And did not get it on 3 dice. That is unfortunate. So essentially a waste of a grit, and it means all 3 of them, or at least 2 of them, can attack me next turn. Well, that's the way it rolls, and he's had fairly decent luck so far, so having a little bit of bad luck, I suppose, is on par. So holding back the darkness, a 5 will fail. So that moves the track and gets a darkness card. And the darkness card is a Chill of the Grave. Undead enemies are +1 initiative and +1 combat. Oh, yeah. You know what? I forgot. I have this Growing Dread card. Growing Dread card says, every hero must make a single willpower save. For each failed save, move the darkness 2 steps forward on the depth track. All right. So his willpower save saves. Okay. That wasn't too horrible. But we do have Chill of the Grave here. And because I failed, and this is the final summoning thing, we have the creature summoning. So 1, 2, or 3 get a lag. Roll that in the box, dude. So we do. So we get a low threat card, making this fight a little more dangerous. We get a corpse pile and a paradise worth of hungry dead. Okay, so let's see how many hungry dead we get. 3. Well, we get 3. 3 hungry dead and a corpse pile. Now these get placed, they're placed normally, so they get come back here like this, like they're coming through the wall, not from the circle. And I may not be able to kill stuff fast enough unless I get really lucky. Okay, so the elite abilities for the hungry dead are a 3 and a 2. The 2 is +2 combat, they're actually +3 because of the Chill of the Grave, and a 3, they're move 3 and initiative 3. Okay, and the corpse pile is a 3 and a 6. The 3 is regeneration, and the 6, you roll twice to spawn extra hungry dead each turn. Wonderful. Alright, so the slashers get to go. They got a move of 5, so he goes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Make sure you guys can see that okay. And then he will go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. He cannot actually get adjacent to me. So there's only 2 of them against me, so there's 2 dice each, hitting on 3s, 2 hits. Okay, oops, This was the front guy, wounded there. All right, two hits, so defense rolls, failed both. So they do a d6 damage each, so 7 wounds. Oh, I probably should have rolled them all separately because I forgot I've got the amulet now. So that's okay, I won't worry about that right now. So 7 armor saves. So saves 3, so that's 4 wounds. That's fine, that puts him to 5. Alright, now Joseph gets to go. He's gonna make 6 horror hits, or terror hits, fear hits, whatever you want to call them, because he's on the same tile as 3. And he makes 4 of them, so he takes 2 sanity. That's not too bad. He's at 4 sanity damage. Alright, and then he will roll for movement. Got a 1. Excellent. So he gets his 1 grit back that he spent, because I think he's going to need them shortly. And then let's shoot again. The way they are, I'm blocked anyway, so I can't. I was going to try to get closer to the Hungry Dead, but I can't do that because they're pretty well blocked. So I need to take out these slashers. Not with a roll like that. All right, I will use a grit to actually re-roll all these. Which is still pretty horrible. But luckily, I should make sure you guys can see all those rolls. You can, okay? Luckily, or good for Joseph, is that he's allowed to re-roll his range to hit re-rolls. And he's got his skill that lets him re-roll 1 die for each gun, and then he has his bandolier, which gives him another re-roll. So, re-roll these dice. Much better. So that's at least something. So 2 sixes gives him 2 more dice. 2 more hits. Okay. So again, 4 better to do a point of damage. I'm going to try to kill him off. So 1 die. A 5. So that will kill him. Which is good. And that lets Joseph heal 1 wound, which he will take as a wound. Yeah, at this point, he'll take a wound. All right. He's got 5 dice left. Let me see. With 6 health, if I roll a 6, that's 3 wounds. So 2 sixes could conceivably kill a slasher. So, but nothing less than that. So I'm gonna roll 3 dice against the slasher that's adjacent to me. So potentially I can, you know what? No, I'm gonna roll all 5. I'm gonna roll all 5. I just wanna kill the slashers. If it takes me 1 per turn, that's fine. Better safe than sorry, so I can spend this grit. And I got 3 sixes. Alright. Well, there you go. So I don't have to grit it. So that's 3, 6, 9 wounds. Should kill 1 more slasher. I'm going to heal a sanity instead of a wound. And then the Hungry Dead get to go. So the Hungry Dead are actually initiative 3. Oh, actually, my bad. I forgot about the Chill of the Grave. Gives them +1 initiative. And their ability gives them initiative 3, +1. They're actually initiative 4. Now, they're not going to be able to reach me, but technically the Hungry Dead go before me. And the corpse pile is in initiative 2, or initiative 1 still. So the Hungry Dead move 2, or sorry, they move 3 because of their elite ability. So 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. So that didn't make a difference. All right. So hold back the darkness. Double sixes. That is a good time for that. So the options are, and this is 7 resolve. I can heal a d6 wounds or sanity, or recover a grit. You know what? I think I'm gonna take. think I'm going to take a grit. I'm going to take the grit. I'm not hurt too badly. I've got my revives. So I'm going to take a grit back. I'm back up to 3 grit. I don't get to roll. Oh, I forgot to roll for the corpse pile. Sorry, the corpse pile guy gets his turn after I did all mine. And the corpse pile rolls twice to see if it spawns any new hungry dead on a 4+. So he actually spawns 2 more hungry dead. So let me get a bunch of hungry dead models here. Okay, so 2 more hungry dead. All right, did darkness roll? So the slasher gets to move. So the slasher will move as far as he can, and he'll come around behind me here. Sorry, make that a little easier. Didn't realize that was quite out of the way. Okay. Then he attacks me with his 2 dice, both of which miss. Well then, Joseph, or the Hungry Dead move. They get to move 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. All right, then it is my turn. So, Joseph's turn. Rolling for movement. 2 3s, doesn't matter. And then he will shoot 7 shots. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. So only one will get in range of me. 100 dead. So you know what? Actually, I think I will attempt to escape the slasher. As a 3+ succeeds. I think I will actually go right here. 1, 2, 3. We'll put him just short. Okay, shooting at the slasher. Actually, although I can't see, won't be able to see any of the hungry dead if I have extra. No, you know what? I'm gonna. No, because I conceivably could get something like 10 hits. In that case, I'd want to put some on some of the Hungry Dead. So, you know what? I'll stay there. I'll take the attacks from one of the Hungry Dead. So, here's my shots. Hitting on 4s. Okay. I don't think I'm going to spend a grit. You know what? It's 4 dice. I do have 3 grit. I will spend a grit for rerolls, because I can always reroll rerolls, so. Excellent. All right, and then, so I have 1 for my skill, 1 for the bandolier to reroll these. Perfect. Perfect. All right, so there's 3 sixes, that gives me 3 extra dice. So that's 3, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 hits. Okay, so I'm going to roll 5. Roll 5 at the slasher. Because I got 5 more shots to lay into the hungry dead. So, 5 shots at the slasher. Alright. That is plenty to kill the slasher. And I will heal a wound. So I'm at 3 wounds, 3 sanity hits, or damage. All right, and then I have 5 dice for Hungry Dead. Now the Hungry Dead are defense 4. So I need a 4 or better to kill them. And I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Looks like I can only see the 2. Yeah, looks like he's... Well, I can see half of his. So I can hit these 3. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So I can hit those 3. So I'm actually going to roll them 1 at a time, starting with the front guys. So I need a 4 better to kill them, and I need to roll it in the box. A 1 will not do it. A 3 will not do it. A 1 will not do it. A 1 will not do it. And a 5. So I killed 1. Which allows him to heal a wound. And then And then we roll for the corpse pile. Does not spawn any. Excellent. Start a new turn. Darkness. 5 will fail. And then I have to roll a die for the darkness. 6 does not spawn any new monsters. Nothing comes through the summoning circle. So the hungry dead get to go. They get to move 3. So 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. All right. So now Joseph gets to go. We'll roll for his movement. 5 and a 4. Okay. I think I'll take the 5. Because I need to come over here and stop this corpse pile. So I'm going to try to escape. Their escape is a 4+. A 6. See that? So that's good. So I can move 5. I go 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. And then Joseph gets to shoot with his 7 dice. He got 4s. No 6s, but a bunch of hits. I do get my skill, lets me reroll 1 of each color, 1 from each gun. Okay, and there's a hit, and then my bandolier lets me reroll, and there's a 6. Excellent, so 2, 4, 6, 8, 9. 9 hits. All right. We'll do one at a time. We'll do the ones in the front there. So a 4 or better on this fellow. We'll do nothing. We'll do nothing. That will kill him. And that lets him heal a sanity. Okay, on the girl. 4 will kill her. And he'll heal wound. Okay, 5 more. We'll roll 2. On him. Well, actually, I guess technically I needed to kill him, and this is the hit doing damage. I had to hit adjacent, so this is the hit on her, and that will kill her because I'm too far to hit this. So I have 3 dice left, 3 hits left to do damage on her. When there's 6, so it doesn't matter what the 3rd die is, and that will kill her. And I'll heal 1 more sanity. And then the corpse pile gets to go. Let's see if the corpse pile spawns any new ones. It does not. Phew! Boy, Joseph is getting a little lucky. Of course, now that I just said that, now it's time to roll back the darkness. Double 5s, Will. Double 5s is a terrifying shriek. Each hero in the mines immediately takes a d6 horror hits. He takes 1, so he will save. He does save. Now, the thing to note, double 5s. It actually counts as a successful holding back the darkness, but a depth event occurred. So that does not trigger rolling for monsters coming through the summoning gate, which is pretty excellent for Joseph. So Joseph gets his movement. I can't take the 1. As much as I would like to get my 3rd grit back, I need to get within range to start shooting this. So I'll have to take 3. And that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That was just enough, just what I needed. So Joseph will take his 7 shots. Okay. He'll spend a grit to reroll these hits. Gets 1 6. All right, and then he's got his bandolier and his skill. Reroll those. Oh, and look at that. Would you know it? That is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 sixes, which gives him 5 more dice. I think this is a record. He's got 5, 10, 13 hits with that roll. That is just amazing. That is exceptionally powerful to be able to read that skill to reroll rerolls for range to hit rolls. But if, especially if you combine it with a grit, and his ability for a reroll with each pistol and the bandolier, which gives him a third reroll, that's just amazing. So, and I have 1 grit left if I need it. It's a defense of 2, so anything but a 1 will deal damage. And I don't think I need it. I think this will kill it. Alright, well, let's see. 7 minus 2 is 5. 7 minus 2 is 5. More than enough to clear off this this corpse pile that came through on the summoning. Whew. Wow. You know, that's pretty good. All right, so Joseph doesn't really matter. He gets to catch his breath for 1. Maybe he'll heal a wound. He'll stay slightly insane with 1 point of sanity damage that will get healed up. Then we draw 2 loot cards because we had two encounters. We had the final one, which was the slashers, and then we had the hungry dead show up. So we get sack of gold dust for 100, and gold nuggets worth a d6 times 50, which is 3, so 150. Not a bad haul for him. He was low on money. There we go. Joseph the man. He's victorious. In the summoning room, beat up, you know, all the enemies. He does a little happy dance. So some final thoughts here. You know, I always get so worried. And this is part of Brimstone, is that it can go very up and down. It can be extremely tough for single heroes to get overwhelmed. It seems, especially with Joseph, is that he needs to survive the first round. And that's really where the big concern is, because everything goes before him. He needs a higher initiative. A higher initiative would be nice, so that maybe he could go before some of the enemies. 4 initiative, there's lots of creatures that get to 4 initiative. You saw the slashers. You saw the tentacle. The tentacles had gotten up to a 4 initiative. Because of their elite abilities, the Hungry Dead got up to a 4 initiative because of their elite abilities. So, getting that, a 5 initiative is kind of that sweet spot, in a way. You don't, from there, other one, you have to get like 7 to get above other things, once you hit 5, after 5, because then you have Hellbats and Void Spiders that theoretically can go higher than that sometimes, but, in general are around 6, so you need to hit a 7 initiative. So a 5 initiative would be nice. Without that, things are moving before him, and they're coming in, they're attacking him, they're swarming him, and he has to survive that initial onslaught of enemies. And then after that, he's just got he's got so many shots with his outlaw pistols. It's just kind of amazing that he's dual wielding. Sure, he doesn't critical, but with Darkstone bullets and just the sheer number of hits that he gets, it's going to be as good as getting critical hits, at least. Those 6s were giving me, a bunch of extra dice. You saw I hit that 13 hits on that corpse pile, just way overkill. But even against the slashers, where I was getting, even just 5 hits or 10 hits, had enough that I could, that I could potentially take one out each turn. So He needs to, and against smaller guys and guys with fewer defense, he can just take out the majority of them, and then he's not swarmed anymore. So for the outlaw anyway, for Joseph, that is sort of the saving grace of playing solo with him. But it is also, you know, again, more up and down swing, more luck and chances. You know, how well does he defend that first assault that he gets attacked with? You know, I thought he was in trouble with those tentacles. The tentacles are just nasty. I mean, you know, three dice doing three damage each, hitting on threes, or I guess they hit on fours. And the sixes ignore your defense. You know, his skull helmet for the armor is a lifesaver. If he didn't have that, he certainly would have needed to make a priority to get some sort of armor, because there's just so much that gets through his defense, especially since I took, you know, the reverse of, you know, with the poor defense to allow him to hit better, which, you know, is kind of good and bad, I guess. It has certainly, you know, been handy to be able to hit on fours. Don't get me wrong. And hitting on fives, I wouldn't have nearly the number of hits that I had. But do I need this many hits? Well, a lot of times I do, but sometimes I don't. Like, there were a number of those 13 hits that were fours. So I wouldn't have gotten 13. I might have gotten 8 or 9, which still would have been plenty to take out, you know, like the corpse pile. But when it comes to critical things like hitting the slashers with their high armor, or even the hungry dead with their high armor, but it's most especially because the slashers have high armor and a number of wounds, where I just can't kill them with one. Even if I get one hit and then roll well for lucky roll for damage, I can take them out. You know, the slashers require a lot of hits because I can't critical to take out, to be able to do damage to overcome their defense. You know, I'm not looking forward to the next leveling up in sort of in that regard, because, you know, the things can get a lot tougher. Things get more armor. You know, the hungry dead get an extra wound. It becomes more challenging in that regard. Of course, the Darkstone bullets, super important for Joseph to get. Every time, you know, he struggles when he doesn't have it. You know, and it becomes super huge just against anything with armor, especially to be able to punch over that armor set, since he can't critical. So it played, you know, it was kind of amazing. I had so many attacks and exploration tokens. The other two weren't in the other direction. They were not attacks. I had attacks all along the way, but they did give him some experience. We'll have to see how close he was. He was halfway, I think, to leveling, or not quite halfway to the next level. He's at 1200 experience. I think he needs, I don't remember how much he needs off the top of my head right now, but you know, he killed a goodly number of things. You know, and of course Joseph got very lucky there at the end, that he didn't, there weren't more things spawning, that he didn't fail the darkness, hold back the darkness rolls very much there at the with the summoning room. And there were a couple rounds, two turns, where the corpse pile with two dice failed to spawn any more hungry dead. That's potentially four more hungry dead. Although, you know, given that next turn I had 13 dice, I had enough to kill the corpse pile and the hungry dead most likely, but you know, you never know. But so he did have some good luck there at times. You know, that's the nature of the game. It's dice rolls, and dice can be fickle, both up and down. Joseph Joseph, to some extent, has some amazing luck, as he should be. You know, the hero of the story. You know, he's just a misunderstood outlaw. He was unjustly accused, and at least that's his story, and he's sticking to it. So that is it for this episode of Joseph Scott's, episode 15. Thank you all for watching, for subscribing. Stay tuned. There may be some more videos in the way. I've just been very busy and had some real life events that have kept me from doing much as far as the other videos, the painting video and a gameplay video for a different co-op game. But those are certainly top of my mind to try to get done, especially the painting video, because I know I've been talking about that for a while. So I really want to get that out to you guys. So, you know, cross your fingers. I can't promise anything, but cross your fingers. I'll get it done before next week's Joseph Scott's video. That is my intent, and we'll see how well that plays out. But again, said thank you all for watching. This is emotionally kind of draining every time I play. It's because it's just so exciting to do well, and then, you know, the highs and lows. Oh, I get hit for a lot, you know, and you never know what's going to happen. It's just, this is a fun game. Thank you all for watching. Thank you for subscribing. And, you know, tell your friends. Go out and buy Shadows of Brimstone if you don't already have it. I highly recommend it. It just has a fun, enjoyable, you know, it's a fun, enjoyable dice rolling. It seems complicated, but it's not. Really, once you get to playing with it, and it's just a lot of fun. You know, we just have so much fun. So, thank you all. Talk to you later.